I just thought that this was the sweetest spring napkin. I love it. I think it is so precious. So we're going to make this work. This is just a surface from Hobby Lobby. You know, it already was black. So I'm thinking, I'm going to try. We're going to try to just apply the crackle medium without applying a base coat of paint and then the top coat. I think it might work. So I'm just using the Folk Art crackle medium. This one came from Hobby Lobby. I'm just going to go ahead and squirt a little bit in a little container. And let's see. We're going to give this a try. So I'm just going to come straight in on my frame. Because, you know, normally we will do a dark coat of paint, let it dry, then apply our crackle medium, and then we apply our top coat, and that's what will give us our cracks. So I'm hoping this will work. Okay, y'all, so I'm just gonna go ahead. I'm not gonna paint where we just crackled it quite yet. We're gonna get a coat on the center. Okay, so now we're just doing our coat of paint around our frame, and I'll go back and do the back, trim out the back also. So I'm just applying an even coat. We're gonna pray this works. It works. It works. I'm gonna rinse that. It had something like gritty almost in it. And a little bit of water actually kind of smooths it. I do want to get inside the lip of that frame. Also, run that up the edges. Carefully set it down. So I am going to go ahead and just cut a section out here. That's really pretty the way it does that, but we're already working with a short surface here. Watch like the water spouts at the beach where it kind of looks like a tornado, but it's over the, you know, over the ocean. I've literally sat on the beach and watched them, and I'm like, okay, is that gonna hop land? And that was scary, but man. And the other thing about tornadoes, it seems like they always come in the middle of the night. It's like, oh, so scary. So you can do this with a paintbrush. Sometimes actually I prefer a paintbrush over these. But we're just gonna kind of just go around fussy cut this per se, but what it does is it feathers it, and it just blends so much better with your background of whatever you're decoupaging onto. It needs to stop curling up on me. And I just take my finger and just kind of pinch it away. Carefully, I don't want to get our little birdie out of there. Alright, so see, we were just fussy cutting that with our water pen, and we're gonna see. I'm scared to touch it, but it's still a little wet. We're gonna see how much of this. Even I'm okay even if that goes over the edge a little bit, y'all. I don't think that would look bad. Maybe just right. Maybe I will take off that piece right there. Just the tip of that. All right, we're just gonna go for it, because if it goes over that bottom slightly, I'm okay with that. So I am gonna apply a coat of Mod Podge to my entire surface. I'm trying to be neat about it. Just to make sure I have it everywhere. Now, carefully, I'm going to lay that down, tap it slightly. If there's any sticking over, it's all right. And then I just grab a chip brush and I just pounce it down. It just really gets it pounced in there, and y'all, it makes it look like it was painted on. Okay, I'll show you what it looks like so far. So I just barely brought, but see how blended that is, y'all? That is so pretty. I love that. I am gonna dry it, and then we're gonna top coat it. We're gonna go over this napkin with some Mod Podge, y'all. This is gonna be good and sealed, right? Let me see if I can get it up in the... It looks like a painting. Okay, let's let that cool off for a moment. Then we're gonna add our triple thick. I think I want a little bit more of this. Okay. Now, it almost looks like I just poured resin on that. Okay, y'all, we're done with all of that. Now we get to bling it up, which is always the part that we're all waiting for, I know. We gotta put some polka dots on the boots. And I think I wanna go with the crystal shimmer. y'all, we're going to be using, again, the rhinestone applicator kit. And then I grabbed some pieces from our Butterfly and Friends, and we're going to be adding that as well. So see, so pretty, right? I love it. Okay, I think the SS16 will actually be perfect instead of the 20. So if you don't, so we're gonna use those. And then this is our little picker pen that helps you pick them up and place them. And I'm not gonna use a heat set. I'm gonna use our fine tip applicator B7000. And I am just gonna come in here and just start making little glue dots on the existing little dots on the boots. And it doesn't set up too fast, so I can do several at one time. Okay. And then you just grab and drop. Try to avoid getting your, because it's like a wax tip, so try to avoid getting your tip in the glue, because you don't want it to break down that wax. I may have to add one, because we may have to create our own little dot in here. Oh my goodness, y'all. That's already looking really, really cute. Show you what it's looking like so far. And that's the shimmer. So it's like the Aurora Borealis. It's going to pick up all the colors. Okay. So let's add some over here. There is our bling. It's hard to tell with this lighting how cute it looks. And then I grabbed some of these tiny little like daisy type flowers. These came from Hobby Lobby in the paper studio section. I'm just gonna dump a few of these out, and we're going to add those in as well. I'm gonna put some down here. I wonder if my little pen will pick these up. Probably. Oh, look at there. Ha ha. That's funny. I didn't know that would work. So your little picker tool works for several different things. We're going to add them up here in our bouquet. It just kind of gives it a three-dimensional look. Come on. Whoop. Actually place that one. And these have a little bit of a shimmer to them also. Add one up here just to keep it balanced. Oh, there we go. Okay. So, see where we just added the little daisies in there. So cute, right? And then, now, let's see, I grabbed a bee, I grabbed a butterfly, and the little dragonfly. I really like that dragonfly, this one. I think we might use the dragonfly. I'll show y'all. This is in the silver pack. And then this is one of my favorite butterflies. It's almost like a mother of pearl. It is just stunning. But I think we're gonna add our dragonfly up here and then our butterfly kind of fluttering around the flowers. That's what I'm thinking. So I'm adding some B7 and some hot glue. I'm gonna put that right down there. And then we're gonna put a little butterfly right there. I wish I thought of this sooner, but that's okay. But I think I want to add a little bit of diamond dust. It's kind of like where it grabs. I'm just kind of, whoa. It's going to grab there, I'll promise you. I could just use that as my little spot to grab more. Kind of sprinkle some up in here and there. And over here. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. Maybe some. Okay. Here we go. I wanted to do it on that lemon. I wanted to do some on our lemon. Okay. Carefully, I'm going to open up this little folder here. And we're going to tap it off. But look at all of that sparkle. I love where the diamond dust just picked up in places, and then you have that bling. So we used crackle. We added a napkin. We used the crystal shimmer out of our rhinestone applicator kit, and we used some pieces from the Butterfly and Friends in the silver collection. And y'all, I just think it turned out precious.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.